I not hearing any sound? Hello, hello, hello? What the hell? I'm not getting any sound here? Hold on one second. Let me check something real quick. Hello? Something don't add up. Let me check something real quick. Why am I not getting any noise? Like, I'm not getting any game audio. Why am I not getting any game audio? This is fucking weird. Something's up. Stop streaming for a couple months on this, and you forget how everything works. Son of a bitch. So why am I not getting any game audio? So why? Make sound come from my TV, but that makes... What's going on? I honestly do not get it. Let's see, that's on. Like, there's something weird going on. And I don't get what. So I guess I got, first things first, before I actually start playing, I gotta troubleshoot this. Okay, so input capture two, yes. This is really quite frustrating. Ah. Let me see if that fixed it. Okay. So, I think we got it rolling. I'm gonna double check one last time. It's all about just balancing the audio. Now that I got everything rolling the way I want it to, I'm just going to adjust this just a tad. Turn that up just a bit. Alright. One last thing. Device. Alright, can everyone... I think everyone can still hear me. Alright, so... Okay, I think we've got it. I think we have what it takes to get this rolling. I'm going to double check one last time. So we're gonna try, let's see what we got. Alright, so right here, this is going to be an actual real test. We're going to test all the audio together along with everything else. Let's see what we got. that should be it. We should be live. You know, I mean, it took me a long time to set everything up. I apologize to everyone watching and waiting. But I think I finally got it. So, if you have problems hearing me or hearing the game audio, or if you think there's a little imbalance, please let me know. Just type something. I'll check regularly to make sure that you guys can hear me and the game audio balanced out well. But anyway, we're going to go get that platinum trophy for this game. I only need one more trophy to get, and it's here in Mega Man X4. I have to complete the zero playthrough. Finally. After all that effort to try and get everything set up. I love the intro to Mega Man X4. Even though they changed it a little bit, they slowed it down in certain parts so that the Hitler salute reference wasn't visible here. They got rid of that. Yeah, kind of sad. Actually get started and beat this game. Then I have to go through and play the other four, which I hate. I do not. I like X1, 2, 3, and 4 way better than I like 5, 6, 7. I've never even touched 8 because I did not like 5, 6, or 7 so much, and I don't know, 8 might be an actual hidden gem for me. I don't know. But I did not like 7 when I played it when it first came out. I did not like 6, I did not like 5. Like X4. I think X4 just set an unrealistic standard for me. It was just, the bar was just way too high after X4. Alright, anyway. Let's go ahead, start a brand new game. And we will be doing the Zero playthrough. Let's get rocking and rolling. Mavericks emerged at 0.5567. They've occupied the Sky Lagoon. This looks like the Repla Force is doing. Repla Force, okay, I'm on my way. So, yeah. Ready. Zero's playthrough is definitely going to be more difficult in terms of playstyle. Because you have to get close to enemies. And I'm already taking in a lot of damage. There we are. That's better. Alright, so we're not going to bother fighting this man, the boss, since there's no point to. Alright. Let's go in here, say hi to your goon real quick. Pretty much he's gonna tell us, yeah, the Sky Lagoon's gonna come crashing down to the ground and we need to get out. Same, very, very similar plot points to the X playthrough. There will be some slight dialogue changes. But that's it. Ready. So here we get to meet Iris. I was like, did you come to save me? Yes, I did. Not really, we didn't even know you were here. But I guess that is the heroic thing to say. The Sky Lagoon is under attack, that's why we're here. We didn't know she was going to be here at all. That's why we were surprised to find her. Alright, so here's the same boss as before, you know. He's pretty easy, just jump slash, you don't. Pretty easy. I mean, even with my clumsy ass getting hit repeatedly, you know, he's no real threat. Zero, long time no see. Colonel, what are you doing here? I've come to save my sister Iris. I hope she's okay. She's fine, I just rescued her. Ah, thanks, sir. I owe you. Now it's more of the same accusations as before of, like, you know, they suspect you become a maverick. And they're like, well, we're not going to cooperate, so it's all out war then. The entire Rebel Force is a group of mavericks. Pretty much all thanks to Sigma. Alright, so. There's my X playthrough, there's my Zero playthrough, so let's go ahead and save over that, and now let's get going.
Brave soldier.
So this is the same cutscene as before, I'm just gonna skip it. Same cutscene as in the X playthrough, but instead of Double being in here, we now have Iris. My brother Colonel started the coup, I know. Please don't fight against him. This must be some kind of mistake. They've occupied several cities already. As a hunter, I must stop them. Nero, I must go now. Okay, so pretty much, yeah, the same Mavericks. Nothing's different about the level design. You know, in terms of, like, what they have or what they offer, it's the same layout, pretty much. And the hard tanks and sub-tanks are still in the same spots they would be in. So first off, let's go ahead and just take out Magma Degree. It's kind of a risky and ballsy move to come here first, considering how the level itself is not good, not that easy. That was close. Just gotta be patient. There we are. Still the kick-ass music we remember from the first playthrough with X. We just gotta race past this part. This is just... I hate that section. Alright, luckily though, just like the next playthrough, every time you go from one half to the other, you get full health. Oh shit. Alright, so let's change how I'm holding the controller. There we are. There we are. First heart tank, much needed. Zero's beam saber is actually pretty dang good. It's great and it's very powerful. A lot more powerful than you would expect it to be. Alright, so we just tunnel under here. And now we're already getting. Come on, Zero. There we are. We get to now fight Magma Dragoon with him. I took one hit with the mech, so I probably won't survive the entire battle with it. Zero, it's really you. Why did you betray us? Answer me, Dragoon. I have no answer for you, my friend. Pretty tough for the first boss fight, but still manageable with the mech. Without the mech, he'd be very difficult for me to beat. I wanted to defeat you, then he appeared. He who? Oh, of course we always know, it's Sigma. You know, yeah, so yeah. Sigma's behind, once again, you know, the manipulation of the Repliforce. Ruinji. Pretty much. Zero's abilities have practically no energy consumption except for one. So that's the cool thing about this. There's no Dr. Light capsules for armor upgrades. We fight against Zero just as is. So now we're gonna go and actually take on Web Spider. The reason I'm gonna go take on Web Spider is because now that I have a new attack. And it's this. You just hold up and triangle. No energy, nothing like that. But as we play through more and more with Zero and we defeat more Mavericks and we get more of their abilities, Zero becomes extremely strong. Not overpowerful. Not overpowered, but really strong nonetheless. A little extra life right there. Another extra life? Wow. That was nice. So yeah, no Dr. Light capsule or anything like that. Ah, much needed health. Alright. Yeah, the flame strike for Zeros is really strong. It's actually the weakness of two Mavericks. It's the weakness of, obviously, Frost Walrus, but it's actually the weakness of Cyber Peacock. So thanks to this ability, and this ability alone by itself, we can go defeat two Mavericks easy. And as you can see, it has multiple instances where it registers for damage. It's such a strong ability. That's why I want it first. Also because it allows us to break these areas, which will get us the heart tank for this mission, or for this stage rather. There you go. we don't have web spider's actual weakness. Like, Zero sometimes won't be able to actually employ a weakness on some Mavericks, and web spider's one of them. You know, like, he's not so, like, remember, when you fought his ex, web spider didn't really have a weakness. I mean, Slash Beast weapon was effective against him, but it didn't trigger a stun on him. Ah, Zero, I've been expecting you. Spider, you work for Reckle Force? Yes, I lead a renegade unit now. There's still time, call off the coup. No, I know where my loyalties lie. And he's about to lie 6 feet under, so let's just go ahead and kill him. So the same battle tactic applies. Deal damage. I can get off two attacks if I get him right as he falls. Right as he drops down. Ooh, that was close. Ooh, managed to get three right there because he dropped low. But yeah, pretty much Web Spider's mechanics are not too hard. Alright, now he'll start the mid-fight. Yep. He's immune right now, but we can go ahead and at the very least... We got him good. All right. So, not too hard. We got Raging Gi, whatever it's called. Pretty much it's an electro sword. Now we're going to use this to go defeat Split Mushroom. I always hated these stairs. The enemy placement on them kind of seems dickish. Come on, Zero. You can make it. Much better. Now it's time for the little ladybug boss, or whatever it's called. So, you know, pretty much the same applies as before.
almost screwed that. Alright, now on to the second half.
Ready.
Much better. Alright, let's get this heart tank. If I don't get it, I'm just gonna die and respawn right here. Ah. Oh well. Let's try that again. Oh, come on, Zero, come on. Come on, Zero, I know you can get this. Alright, so I'll dash jump over there, and then I'll quickly just do a regular jump. There we are. See? Like, I know what to do, it's just sometimes Zero doesn't want to do it. As you can see, like, there was a lot of instances where it was trying to check for damage. Like, a lot of damage checks going on right there. Alright, time for Split Mushroom. We'll actually be able to get to see more of his actual fight style this time around, because my new attack only affects him in certain parts. You made it this far, I'm impressed. You interested in a real challenge? Who's your commanding officer? Never mind that, it's time to fight. So just by standing still and pressing triangle, it'll allow you to do that. It'll allow you to shock him. Otherwise, he just kind of like stays up there and you can't really do much. But at the very least, it gets rid of his illusions. So just like Gemini Man, you just gotta look for the real one. But he's pretty easy once you understand him. If I don't destroy these clones, they'll be jumping all over the place. So let's just go ahead and kill this bastard. So yeah, you got to see more of his fighting style than with X, whereas in the X playthrough, you just jumped and shot lightning web at him, and it just kept shocking him repeatedly as he jumped from wall to wall. So it was really unfair. Nothing you could do about that. Or nothing he could do about that. With the correct timing, higher and further jumps are possible while airborne. Kunzan may be activated while attacking in the air. Alright. Now we're going to take on Frostwalkers. For two reasons. One, because we can easily get the heart tank in just about everything this level, this stage has. And we'll get the ice attack, which is the vulnerability of the Colonel. Even though at the halfway point we would fight the Colonel, this time we won't. We don't actually fight him. So it really didn't matter. I didn't need to come to Frost Walrus' stage. I just felt like it. But yeah, we have two energy tanks and a weapon tank here. the ability we learned. We learned a double jump, and we can do a spinning blade attack. The double jump really helps with Zero's mobility. It's so much better than having to rely on, like, lightning web like X had to. However, you cannot air jump, and you cannot dash jump and then double jump. Oh, I'm an idiot. Let's try that again. So up here, we got this thing. I don't know what it is, it doesn't really do much, but I got it. And that's all that matters. Now for the frozen, I guess, elevators you'd call them, whatever they're. Alright, now for mid-boss, and we're just gonna obliterate this mid-boss, no problem. Previous playthrough, when I did this, I almost one-shotted the boss with this with my fire attack. Like, it literally left him down with just a sliver of health left, and then I just walked up to him, slashed him once, and he was dead. So I don't know why it didn't let me do it this time. I guess maybe the first time I just got lucky with, like, hit detection, and the boss didn't go invulnerable like he should have. Our weapon tank. There's only one Zero ability that we'll ever need to use it for, but we have it at the very least. So yeah, we're just building up weapon energy, but it doesn't matter, we're at the battery. Dun, 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 dun. Music for Frost Walrus' stage is so nice and relaxing. Which is the polar opposite of his personality. He's like, probably the most aggressive of the Mavericks in this game. What's that blunt get up to? I don't have time for you, Junior. Hey, shut up and fight already. Oh, that does it, you're going down. So. Oh crap, wrong button. So, yeah, kind of similar to the X fight. So pretty much when we're in the air, we press down and the triangle attack, and it lets us do an downward ice stab. And anyway, we've got a message from the Repliforce. It's the Colonel. I'll be waiting at Memorial Heart. Be there. Yeah, so pretty much what would be the fight in the X playthrough, this is just an actual cutscene.
Disappointed in you, Colonel. What do you think you're doing? It's not too late. Stop the coup now. If that's your decision, prepare yourself.
I'm afraid that one of you may end up.
Someone must stop Repliforce.
Zero!
So, yeah, that's pretty much it. Alright, now back on to the Maverick Hunt. Alright, next up. So, we don't really have the soul body like X had, but we do have the way of getting through here. The jumping slash attack is actually the weakness of those orbs. So we just have to jump every time we're about to run into them, and then attack, and we're good. So, in this, you know, just like the X playthrough, we're graded in three sections. First section gave us an extra life. The second one will give us a heart tank. And then the third one will be the energy tank. Whereas in the X playthrough, the third one would be a Dr. Light capsule. But as Zero does not have a Dr. Light, Zero does not receive Dr. Light capsules because he's not one of Dr. Light's machines. He was not created by Dr. Light. But as you can see, the double jump just makes things so much easier. Can actually start gaining extra health and saving it up for boss fights. Thank you. Cyber Peacock stage, the second half of it is just a freaking cakewalk. Like, no challenge whatsoever. Still the best intro in this game.
I'm impressed you made it this far, but you can't beat me. Get ready!
So yeah, it's surprising how Magma Dragoon's weapon is actually the weakness of him. I don't know why. So yeah, he's just a little trickier because sometimes I might accidentally push up or diagonal on the analog stick on the controller and it might not register up, it might register to the side, so it might be thinking do the electric attack and not the fire attack. I don't even know why they try to pronounce these, but anyway, Giga Attack button. So pretty much R2. And it sends out a bunch of attacks. It sends out a bunch of, like, energy blasts in all directions. But this one, that is the one that actually has a limit to what, how many times you can do it. Anyway, let's go to Jet Stingray. So I'm on the lookout for that heart tank. There it is. Heart tank acquired. Now I can just go ahead and continue on, get past this part. Alright, second half. Just by simply dashing, you know, the revved up, like, burner attack or whatever. Got it. Nice flawless gameplay of Jet Stingray's level. Usually I die at least once because I have to redo one of the sections for the heart tank or the energy tank, but this time I didn't. So this is how you do it. You gotta time it just right. I should let him get a little lower. There we are. But as long as we repeat this formula, we should be fine. But if I'm a little too slow, he'll do stuff. Like diving underwater, trying to do his little torpedo attack. And if I'm too early, he'll be too high and I might miss him. So that's kind of the challenge with Jet Stingray when you're at zero, is timing your attack just right. Whereas X, you can just trap him in the top corner of the screen and never have to worry about him. But even still, he can just be trapped in an infinite loop if you're good enough. Like I said, Zero is powerful, so long as you're able to execute the moves in a somewhat precise manner.
You won,
dash button while jumping. So, we got the air dash. We literally got an air dash. What used to be a Dr. Light capsule for Mega Man is now just a, you know, like, I don't even know. So anyway, Storm Owl time. We'll get Slash Beast last. Definitely want as much energy as I can for our tanks. How are we doing on that? Yeah, abysmal. Alright, so our tank, got it. Almost died right there. First F done. Now if you look at the health right next to my health bar, you'll see another bar. That's the energy bar for the weapon. It's always equipped. All I have to do is just press R2 to use it, but we only have 4 uses of it. Aw, damn it. I want that. That's a large one too.
Why did you join us as Mavericks?
Wait, stop the coup. God, Zero, they're never gonna stop. Like, I don't know why he keeps doing that. That's the attack. But notice how little damage it does. It does very little damage, so we're gonna have to use regular attacks anyway. If he grabs us, he'll pick us up and slam us into the ground.
He
got to see him use his main attack, which was the storm tornado thing, where he pretty much, or the double cyclone, where he throws out the cyclone balls like X does, because that's the ability X gets from him, is where he just throws out little balls of little cyclone blasts at the opponent, and they kind of track you, but not really. Enhanced Z Saber, you can cut enemy energy shots with your saber. So now our saber is purple instead of green. I don't think it makes it stronger, I could be wrong, but I mean it might. Slash Beast's attack is probably the most useless one, because it's a dash attack. You dash and then you do a quick slash. Anyway, yeah, there's our new purple saber. Give me some health. We are getting quite a good amount of health. I mean, yeah, that's actually a good chunk of health we got right there for, let me check. Yeah, see? The first sub tank's almost full. Zero is at this point really strong. I mean, his health bar is almost maxed. All right, time for a boss fight. This guy's gonna be a lot harder than a little bit harder. I mean, you know, it doesn't take much effort to kill him. But X, all X had to do was shoot two plasma shots at the ball at that thing, and it would die. So, we still have yet to get the heart tank for this mission, so we gotta get it as soon as we get our little mech armor. Bastards have actually done a fair bit of damage on me. Set the Maverick. We just gotta go through this last section. Now, Slash Beast is the only Maverick that we really don't have a strong weakness, you know, for. Like, so we're gonna see everything that he can do.
You take part of my unit, I'm gonna enjoy fighting you.
Damage unnecessarily there in the beginning. But yeah, he's actually able to do everything he wants. We're not able to trap him in some type of a repetitive pattern. At that point, if I were to attack him, I think he'd try and counter me. Whenever I see him do that, I just back off and he does nothing, so I'm pretty sure it's like a counter guard ability of his. I've never really triggered it ever as zero. Probably should have tried it just once. I had enough health, I think I would have lived. But anyway, we get ship pulled up. Alright, so while dashing, you can execute a powerful dash attack. Approach your enemy with Shippuga and perform a combo. And we got everything. We got all the heart tanks, all the abilities, everything. Rebel Force is at the space harbor. I have to go. No, please don't go. Blah, 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 blah. So first things first. Let's go to the snow base and let's get some items.
Ready!
It's funny how it didn't even do anything to him. Alright, and that's that. We are maxed out and ready to go. Well, not maxed out on lives, but it doesn't matter. Jesus. time to actually fight the Colonel for real. I don't want to fight Step Back. I'm sorry, I can't let you through. Iris will be sad if she loses you. Don't be too presumptuous, Zero. Save it until after you defeat
him. I've been waiting to fight with you.
I don't want to lose. Impressive, Zero, but it's too late. What? Repliforce has left for space. Reploids in space! They've left for outer space. Scramble all Maverick Hunters. Iris, where are you, Iris? She left with them? No! But before that, more health.
Ready!
More and more health. It almost perfectly does half.
Ready.
I don't know why Zero going, yeah, always makes me smile. I don't know why. Even though I'm done with X. Alright. Now comes the most tear-jerking fight of them all. We have to go defeat Iris. How sad. She is. So you fought with my brother. I'm sorry. Then it's over. Everything. Wait, Iris, listen to me. Goodbye, Zero. So the key to beating Iris is you have to get the crystal out of her. She's actually not too. She's not a, you know, a cakewalk. With enough strikes and blows to the crystal, we defeat Iris. And then, an awkwardly voiced, yet kind of emotional scene takes place.
Iris! Iris!
Sarah.
Hang in there, Iris.
Please. Stay away from Rippler Fox. Let's live together in a world where only Reploids exist.
Iris, there's no world just for Reploid. It's only a fantasy.
Yes, I know, but I wanted to believe it. I wanted to live in a world where only Reploids exist with you.
Iris! 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 Ah! No, this isn't happening! There's no reason for me to go on! What am I fighting for?
A little bit of a voice crack in there. But anyway, yes, we killed Iris, and she's never coming back. Which is weird, because Zero was killed in Mega Man 1, and we rebuilt him. So I don't know why we just don't rebuild her. You know, I'm pretty sure that we could obtain, like, the schematics for her or something, you know, like, to be able to bring her back. Anyway, you can choose which way to go. I like to go this way. Oh, crap. Whoa, that was close. Alright. Dang, I'm getting my ass kicked. Ah, full health. How I love you full health tanks. Now we fight the general. General, many died because of you. Those lives are on your conscience. Independence always has a high price. What about Iris? Did you forget her? I have no regrets. Come on, Zero.
Show me your true power.
Stop. Oh, I hate this little fist attack that he does. I hate it so much. I want him to do something different. Like, I'm not gonna waste a heart health. I'm not gonna waste my health on that. Do something different, you bastard. Like, don't just stand there and do that. Because I have to get close in order to hit him. And that's one thing I hate about the general fight with Zero.
Show me your true power.
No, god damn it. I'm just gonna try and get in one or two hits. Thank you. loves to do this. When I was playing as X, he almost never did this. I was hoping he would just lower it. I should have been doing more of that from the start instead of just running from him. I forgot there are times where he sinks low and he kind of waits a little bit. I'm not the best at fighting in general with Zero. So yeah, pretty much the weapon is out of control. Someone else is controlling it. Blah, 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 blah. Let's go fight Sigma now. Gotta get some more health though.
Ready.
Probably gonna need it. Before we even go fight Sigma, we have to go defeat the bosses at a boss rush again.
Ready.
Here we go. Let's go on. Let's get on with this boss rush.
Ready.
Got 7 lives. If I die here because I don't feel like healing, that's fine, you know, I don't really care. Oh, by the way, the slash beast attack might work against this guy, but unfortunately he never gets low enough for me to use it. So, it's unfortunate. Had enough of you. Magma Dragoon. This guy's gonna be a bit of a challenge, because...
Thank you.
Shoryukens and the Shoryukens of the world. So, at this point, it's pretty much, you know, simple repetitive patterns. The good thing is I get health every time I come out, so it's worth it. Stoobell, huh? Yeah, that does a good chunk of damage. Timed it wrong. Ah, crap. Oh, he tried to do that. Yeah, bastard. There we are. Sucker. Fuck you and your fucking ugly toilet water. Time for the walrus. Yep. All right. mushroom should be easy. I should be able to take him out with taking no damage. That way I can be at full health for Slash Beast. Or damn near full health. No damage. Good, because I'm going to need that full health for Slash Beast in case things go south fast. Yeah, so it's not full health, but it's close enough. I should be okay. Probably should have taken on Slash Beast first. Never saw him do that before.
Ready.
Alright, I see you, Slash Beast. Alright. I've never had him do that before. That was new. I've always either killed him with X or I've never seen him do that with Zero. If I didn't kill him there, he was going to run into me and kill me. Dang! Slash Beast taking me to the edge. Lo and behold, it's Sigma. Good work, Zero. You're Sigma, so was you. Yes, simply brilliant. You even defeated Colonel and Iris. You made me do it. No, you wanted to destroy them. Allow me to remind you that I was once the leader of the Maverick Hunters.
What's our current situation?
Commander!
Where's that red Maverick that wiped out Garma's unit?
He's inside that door.
You may leave now. I'll take care of this personally.
By yourself, Commander?
I don't want any more of my people being sacrificed.
Hmm? Commander Sigma. Incredible. Now I'm certain there's no one who's a match for the commander. What?
Take that Red Maverick to the repair center and call Dr. Kane. I wish to have that Maverick studied.
Commander, are you okay?
Silence!
Zero, you were a Maverick. What's your point? Are you that surprised? Oh, Zero, you're most impressive. So, yep, now it's time to defeat Zero, and the tables have turned. Zero and Sigma fought long ago as Maverick and Maverick Hunter, but now the roles are switched.
Prepare to become space dust.
So the first rule applies, you know, just like always. Oop, too high. Scythe took a lot out of me.
Are you ready for round two?
I've been waiting for you, Zero. It's time for us to settle this. Nice and flawless, what I like. But yeah, pretty much, you just bait him into throwing it into the wall. Don't let him throw his scythe into the ground, otherwise he'll summon these little boomerangs that'll home in on you. But if you just throw him into the wall, and then just do what I did and get behind him, you can actually stand behind him without taking damage. You're finished, Zero. Iris is waiting for you.
Prepare to become
okay.
Space dust.
I always hated that line. I always hated that line. Subtank right now. Let's get it. We're committed to this fight.
Ah!
want to risk it. What's so fun? This weapon is aimed at Earth. No one can stop it. No. Goodbye, Zero. We'll meet again, you son of a bitch. But who could it be? It's the General. Zero, I was wrong. Sigma, he blinded me to the truth. It's okay, rest. With my body, I can stop the weapon. But then you'll... It's over for this soldier. Farewell, General!
So, this is what happened to me. This is my fate. I couldn't save anyone after all. Iris!
It's over. I finally managed to beat the game as a Zero. So I should be getting a trophy at some point now. Keiji Inafune. Let's see. Let's just wait until it plays all the way through. That was close. I almost screwed that. But yeah, I finally managed to beat this as Zero, and that should literally be the last trophy I need for the Platinum, so I guess we gotta wait for this to finish? Which is a little... That's a little weird, you know. Normally they triggered right when I beat Sigma. Let me check and make sure. Is that the last one I truly do need? Anyway, complete Zero's story in Mega Man X4, which I did. And then that's literally it. I just need this one and it'll automatically give me that. So why is it... Well, I'll just let it play through. Maybe there's a scene afterwards? SA Class Hunter, Platinum Trophy. The battle has ended, but for some reason, Zero's memories of the past continue to haunt his mind. As a hunter, it is his duty to go on after those Mavericks. And at the same time, he knows his destiny to defeat his friend one day. Two different people, two different fates. In the future, Zero's decision will lead to two great hunters to a tragedy. The future is coming. There we are. So yeah, Mega Man X4 was really when the series got really dark, and it's like leading up to X and Zero having to fight to kill each other, because they were both created for that purpose. Zero was created for the sole purpose of killing X and Dr. Light, because he was created by Dr. Wily. But anyway, that's going to do it. I've finished all of X4. I've done the X playthrough, I've done the Zero playthrough, so I'm just going to sit back, watch this one more time, and then I'm going to end the stream. I want to thank you all for joining me. I greatly appreciate it. That's the first four X games down. I've gotten platinum on this, and all the first four X games are done. Now we gotta move on to the second half of the X games, X's 5, 6, 7, and 8, which I don't like. I think 5 is overrated, I think 6 is ass, and I think 7 is trash. I've yet to play 8, so hopefully 8 will be worth it. I don't know. I've never touched 8. After everything that happened, oh, hello puppy. I got my little beagle right here, Chloe the beagle. Yeah, hi, you hear me ranting and raving up here, yeah, screaming and stuff. What, you come up here? Oh. Anyway, that's going to do it for me. Thank you all for watching. I appreciate it. And that will do it for me. I will check you guys all later in my next live stream. Stay tuned for more, and that will be it.